talk to the mayor, by the commission work whenever possible, so if you want to communicate with me, just give me your money. I've learned to do all this. I've had some help from vocational rehabilitation. It's fine. Anyway, so yeah, vocational rehabilitation was designed to help people with disabilities. They paid for my education and were recently funded by our business. They bought my car and customized it as well. They had a guy come to my apartment and install custom ergonomic furniture, such as self-adjusting tables, a sink on top of the sink in the apartment. It's higher, so I can don't have to bend over and wash my hands much. And a few of the materials I've constructed and built them, built other things with them. I really enjoy making things with my hands. Any kind of power tools. As far as income, I'm fortunate enough to qualify for Social Security disability insurance. That pays for all my living expenses. And Section 8 housing pays the majority of my rent. This has always been a source of shame and humiliation for me. I hate feeling like a failure. I've had many jobs over the years. My first job was about working at Humble Zoo. That really sucked a lot. My last job was doing data entry at a mortgage company, which I actually liked. It wasn't too bad. I didn't start really painting actual things until 2002. My first exhibit was in 2006, and it was a collection of flowers. At the time, I was using acrylic paints, but now I use oils. Well, okay, I love flowers. The detail that actually exists combined with growing color makes me all excited and think really fast. Though I still stop to stare at flowers wherever they are, I started painting more figurative art and using more realistic color palette. Currently, I'm working on what I call the syndrome series, which focuses on the physical and psychological aspects of my life. Miller syndrome affects so many areas of my life. I could talk all day, luckily I don't have to. There's a few things though I will tell you about. Appearance, an obvious area is I look different. This has been and still is really difficult for me, resulting in extreme anxiety and depression during my school years for about 13. I lived in denial that I looked different. I became hyper-focused on watching how normal people socially articulate themselves, that I talked to their every move the best I could. From thinking of a drink, I usually crush my soda. I'll crush it so it's in the middle so that it's easier to hold. And all posture, all body. Hold something, how you move when you walk. Everything is you know, been, I try to imitate that. And it's worked over the years, and now I'm kind of trying to regress and stop doing what I think I need to do. Because this is the catalyst for my OCD. I succeeded my illusion of normalcy until after I graduated from high school. In my early 20s, my bubble started to crack. I tried to keep it intact with excessive amounts of alcohol and marijuana. That didn't work for some reason. It was just time to make things harder. Weird, right? Anyway, my bubble broke completely. I didn't load it. there are any things that are just going to cause major problems in my day-to-day activities at short. 6'1", and I have these short arms. They don't have any restoration. Many simple tasks are hard to do and sometimes painful, like putting on my seatbelt, washing my hands, drinking, taking pictures, painting, typing, working on a computer, using keys, unlocking things, taking my pills even, and playing games. It's painful holding up the iPhone. I do play it a lot. Something as simple as routine in my jean pocket for some change to get, like my buy coffee, for example. I have to get in it like this, you know, and fiddle around, and I hope, you know, they're not thinking that. because of it, actually, I used to get everything ready when, say, when it's 7-Eleven, I would get my drink, but then I would go to the side and get change out, the money out, so that when I get up and pay for it, I just pay for it, and I'm done. And hopefully I don't get any change back, because it always spills. But to avoid it altogether, I just use credit cards. At the grocery store, I have trouble holding on to the card in a way that will apply enough leverage to maintain control of it. Because I have to hold on to it like this, and push basically with my thumbs. I tend to try and pull on to the rounded corners in the back like that, or, and I often never do this, I push it, shove it as hard as I can, and then I have to walk behind it. that works. I have a lot of pain, mostly in my back, due to having short arms. I call it mechanical pain, because it is really, because I have to do everything, I have to accommodate by punching my back, doing everything you would do with your wrist, I kind of have to do with my elbow. So when you pick up a drink, you know, I have to bend down this, or I have to use the other hand, pretty much. I mean, I need to think of some examples or something.
So,
Also, there are some bones in my lower spine that are fused that shouldn't be, and some bones that aren't fused that should be. Both of my knees are susceptible to going out of place due to the lack of a groove behind the patella, which normally would prevent the kneecap from sliding side to side. So I actually did tear some cartilage in my right knee back in 99, rollerblading, and that caused a lot of issues actually. I just don't want to have another surgery to get hips. There's also a lot of pain in my hips if I stand too long, or walk too long, and my shoulders if I use them wrong. You know, if I sometimes you know, seatbelt, you know, if I pull something or I'll hurt my shoulder, itching, you know, actually itching and trying to scratch something on my back or whatever, it's, I tend to hurt myself. There's no words to describe what I have to endure day in and day out. Fortunately, after years of working out the kinks, my pain caused my health problems somewhat. Having pain is managed because I like being as active as I possibly can. I love to golf. Golf makes me happy. Usually. When I'm golfing well, it makes me happy. Happiness hasn't been easy to come by. I'm fortunate that I have some great doctors at the University of Utah. Through many years of trial and error, we finally found the right mix of antidepressants and other medications other than Miller's, like obesity and depression. Ultimately, however, it comes down to affecting myself. And I'm still working on that. I'm not nearly as close as these two. They have a lot more acceptance.